In last week's newsletter, we asked if anyone had ever experienced a hostile reaction after setting a boundary. Today, we have a heartbreaking story from a listener who did everything right and still faced hostile backlash. A listener wrote in about her situation. She and her husband, they live across country from both of their families, and part of the reason is she just wanted some distance and space between her and her mom. While she was 6 months pregnant, her mom called and said, "Hey, can we come visit around Thanksgiving?" And the timing was, you know, they could celebrate Thanksgiving, but also her son that was due would be about 3 months old at that time. She said, "Yeah, of course, but please, before you book the flights, just confirm the dates so that we are fully available and can entertain you to like the fullest extent." The next call, her mom, dad, and both grandmas had booked their flights for an 8-day stay at their house without checking with them. She and her husband were so disappointed and really frustrated, but they decided, okay, what's done is done. Like, let's just let them come. And when they're here, we'll just explain to them going forward how important it is to check with us first on the dates before you spend the money and book the flights. Well, they actually got to talk before that because in her ninth month of pregnancy, she had a baby shower and her dad came and visited for the shower. And there was a moment where it was her dad, her husband, and herself. And so she thought, great, I'll just take this as an opportunity to share with my mom my thoughts about, you know, future visits. So she just said, "Hey mom, do you think next time before you book the flights, you can just confirm the dates with us first? Because now with a baby and our work schedules, everything's going to be really chaotic. And when you visit, I really want the chance to soak you up and I want to be fully available." Her mom did not take that well. She dismissed the request, claiming, "I did verify the dates," but she hadn't. Her mom then locked herself in the bathroom next to the kitchen, sobbed so loudly. Then once she was done there, she went outside, cried again really loudly. Her dad had to go out and comfort her. She ignored her for the rest of the trip. She had 2 days left. She ignored her daughter and was rude to everybody else. Now, anytime her mom wants to come visit, she makes a huge deal, making lots of sarcastic comments about having to ask permission to come and see her grandchild. First, I just want to say, you did everything right. You must have a lot of experience setting boundaries with someone who either has a high conflict or a sensitive personality. And I'm sure over the years and just all the time, it takes a huge mental toll. What you did was exactly how I teach setting boundaries with someone with that type of personality. You shared your limit, your boundary, but you did it in a way, you framed it in a way that, like, this is how it's going to benefit you. You told her that if you check with me first, I'm going to be fully available. And this is going to make her visit, like, incredibly better. It is heartbreaking that your mom responded with such a strong, big emotional reaction. I mean, locking herself in the bathroom, ignoring you at your own baby shower, all the while you were 9 months pregnant, and then for the 2 days she still had remaining of the trip. I am so sorry you had to go through that. This, like I said, this is what I teach, and it reminds me of a free resource that I created when you're going to set boundaries with a high conflict or a sensitive personality. So it is really tough. It feels almost impossible to set limits with someone who reacts really emotionally, and they make you feel like a monster for setting the smallest limit. How you do it is framing the boundary in a way that benefits them while still protecting your peace. For anyone listening, if you're dealing with a high conflict or sensitive person and you feel like this free resource might help you, it touches on why they are the way they are, like why they're so emotional, like kind of what's going on with their brain. I share 25 boundary scripts. So I walk you through these 25 scripts of the most common boundary scenarios. I also break down the boundary like formula. So if your situation wasn't in one of the boundary scenarios, which they're vast, it's really good. All I have to do is just plug it into this formula and you can customize your own script in a way that makes sure they know if you respect this request, it's going to really benefit you. And then I also share with you how you mind your boundary with those that like to make it their life's mission to push your boundaries. If you're interested in this resource, all you have to do is just comment 25 below and then we'll send you all the details. Oh, thank you, thank you, thank you to the Mind Your Boundary community for being here and just continuing to support each other. This is such a beautiful and insightful place and I'm just honored to be a part of it. YouTube thinks you're going to like this one now. And until next time, friends, make sure you keep minding your boundaries. Bye.